Hello everyone, it's Abby. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today's cash stuffing video is for July paycheck number 1. And that feels so good to say again because I haven't filmed in 2 weeks. I took like a really good rest from all my social media accounts. If you follow me on Instagram and here on YouTube, like I completely was out of it. And I'm gonna tell some of it a bit later. But I feel like I have like a week worth of contents that I need to catch up on. So after I film this, I'm definitely going to catch up with y'all posts and see what you guys are up to. Really, really excited for that. And yeah, for today's cash stuffing, I have $320 in here. I don't have to stuff my cash envelopes because I got my paycheck last Friday and it's already like Thursday. So I'm only gonna stuff my sinking funds and my monthly bills, but I just want to share something new. I've been using this wallet size like bag lately, and it has a really thick strap that makes it, you know, not awkward to bring. And what I like about this, you guys know that I don't like the bulky wallets, but I'm so obsessed with this lately that I've been using this like every time I go to the grocery, just buy something, do some errands, and I'm gonna show you. So it has a really large compartment in here that you can my AirPods fit in here, and then my cash envelopes are here, and then I just put my cards in here, but I got it off first. And then on front we have this huge pocket where I can put my phone. This is my sister's phone, but we have the same anyway. I mean same dimension or same phone. And voila, it really works. And then I just hang my car keys in here, and oh my god, life changer. Like I can't. And now I'm gonna proceed to tell you guys, you know, some bits of stories of what happened to me lately while I've been out. It's not that like grand of a deal, but I just really want to express this also in this channel. But trigger warning, I'm gonna talk about some mental my mental health, and also like gaining weight or weight gain. So if that kind of triggers you, definitely skip this ahead because I will definitely talk about it. Okay, so the reason why I'm out is because my mental health isn't really good lately. Like, I'm not okay. And sometimes I keep asking myself, what's wrong? Because is it like this? Is it because of that? And I keep denying those problems. Like, it's too shallow. Maybe it's not about it. It shouldn't be like that because that one is a small thing to think about, to the point that I just break down or had a meltdown a few like days ago. And another trigger was I was at Ross. I was shopping for more clothes for the upcoming trip, and then I got this dress that I want, and I got it on my usual size. So I was fitting it, and then you guys know that awkward position where the dress is already over your head, and then you're trying to fit your arms and your shoulders into the dress and it won't fit. That moment it was a very awkward angle, if you can imagine the position of the dress on me. And I saw myself in the mirror and I just blurted out, like, you look ridiculous. Like, oh my god, why did I say that to myself? Like, it was that moment that instead of saying, it's okay, you can just find another dress, it's okay, the dress doesn't work for you, it's okay, you're still beautiful. No, I didn't say that to myself. Like, I said so many hurtful things to myself in the mirror. Because, you guys, I'm seeing myself, like, my stomach, my arms, my face. It's just like, what happened to you? Why are you like this? Like, it's been a while since I looked myself through the mirror that intense. And yeah, I broke down. Imagine like 1 minute of me on that position, just silently crying in the dressing area of Ross. And I was like silently crying, and I really pitied myself that moment. I just went straight home, cried myself, and then sleep. Then that kind of opened my mind that maybe there's something really is a problem, because I don't have also my menstruation for almost 4 months now, and I keep asking myself, is it because of my hormones? Do I feel like this not okay, because is it my hormonal imbalance, or is it because of other factors? And that's the thing, you know, it's very tricky because you don't know what's causing the problem. So I really had to take a break from everything and just, you know, because my brain was fuzzy, my brain was foggy and hazy. So that's why I took a step back from life, from some responsibilities in life. And that's when I tried to change my routine. Definitely the first step for me was to, you know, help myself. Like, what are you gonna do now? I mean, you have that problems, you don't feel okay, so what are you gonna do now? And I totally did a lot of self-care routine. I've been working out 20 to 30 minutes almost every day. I've been catching up on a lot of K-dramas, because K-dramas is like my escape from reality, and it's a good entertainment, to be honest. So yeah, I've been taking myself out for lunch during the 4th of July celebration. I've been out on like lunch by myself in not so fancy restaurant, but not a fast food. So I really treated myself. I've been curling my hair for a few consecutive days already just to feel good, and I've been writing like self affirmation. Those small steps definitely help, and I'm not saying that I'm completely healed or I'm completely okay, but it's at the point that a few of those clouds have been lifted off, and I feel like I can go on with my life with what I used to do. So now, you know, I'm getting back there. I feel like I talk way too fast. I'm so sorry, but that's overall what have been happening for the past few days. And I just wanted to tell this story or say this because I wanted to share it also to, you know, a weight has been lifted off my shoulders. And I think like internet friends are really, really good listeners, and they, you know, just support you. They you know, their presence itself is really good, aside from your like close friends and your family. And I just also want to say that if you're struggling with like the same things, or if you're just struggling in general and you just want to pour your heart out, my DMs and Instagram are open. Even my comment section is a safe haven for you guys, so definitely you can share whatever you like and people will listen to you, and your feelings are valid. They are not just in your head, other people are experiencing it too. You're not alone in this, and we got this. Like, so yeah. Oh my god, I feel like this is a really long intro. Wait, let me check. Oh my god, the intro is quite long, but yeah. Again, my DMs are open always for you guys. And now let's proceed to the cash stuffing. Okay, so as I mentioned, only sinking fund and monthly bills will be stuffed today. And I'm gonna start with my sinking funds over here. For future home, I'm not gonna put anything, but this one has $2,950 already. I was itching to put $50 in here just to close the $3,000 amount off, but I keep reminding myself that if my adventure money for the end of the month trip lacks, I'm still gonna get money from here, so what's the point, right? So I'm just gonna put everything in adventure first, then freedom money or my 3 to 6 months bills. It's gonna get $10. So now we have 560. I hope this one is centered. Okay, next is my envelope or my wishlist envelope. I will get $15. I emptied this out. But it's okay, we're just gonna build this back. And then vacation won't get any. I'm putting all my trip money in my adventures envelope. So the whole month of July, I'll be focusing on this envelope. And right now we're just gonna put $50. So we have 20, 10, then a lot of five. I'm thinking of putting a lot of 5 because, you know, we might spend it on food, on some things while going around. So let's just put small denominations. So right now, adventurers or pocket money has 20, 40, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 10, 20, 30. So we have 130 for adventurers. My goal is 250 or I guess 300. And then every excess will probably go to my future home or to some other sinking funds. Then dentist will just get 5. So dentist has 50, 100, 40, 50, 60. Okay, why am I talking too fast? So we have 160 for dentist. And then health will not get any. Then gifts will get 5. I only have 15 in here. The next one is my sister's birthday. So we have 20. And I think she wants like a gym accessory. I don't know. I'm gonna ask her again. But I'm preparing for that at the end of the month. So Christmas or holiday will get 10. Okay, I'm speeding up my savings for this one because I realized that it's really coming up. So I might be too confident. So I have 50 70 90 100 10 20 30 35 40 43. So we have 143 here. My goal is around 150 or 200 within that range. Then car needs or car maintenance will just get 5. So I have 50 70 90 100 105. Oh my gosh. And have 6 7 8 9 10. Okay, we have 110 for car needs. And then taxes won't get any. Then electronics will get 5. I told you guys in my previous video that I'm selling my MacBook, I mean 2015 MacBook Pro, and I'm just waiting for the right like offer. And someone offered me like $50 off from my asking price, and I'm seriously thinking if I should if I should sell it at that price. So I need more time to decide, but probably I will just let it sell that price. So we have 5 10 15 20 for electronics, and after selling that, all the money will just go in this envelope anyway. YouTube won't get any, beauty won't get any, and wow, that's everything. Oh no, wait, YouTube will get 25. I forgot. And you guys will know later why. You guys will know why I put 25 in here. But yeah, that's it for my sinking funds. Okay, so it's kind of shadowy. I apologize because the sun is already setting. But next is my monthly bills or the not so fun bills. Oh my gosh, I forgot that I have money here. I don't know what's this for. Okay, I'ma solve the mystery later. But for now, let's just stuff what's in my budget. So for rent will get $60. And y'all, July is a magic month. So I have 3 bi-weekly paycheck this month. I'm really excited for that. Then car loan will also get $60. Oh no, it's utilities. Okay, why is my head really not... Okay, let's do car loan first. Car loan will get 60. Oh my god, there's too much bills. I'm too lazy to count. Okay, let's count. So we have 50 70 90 110 130 150 70 80 90 200 205 210 220 230 240 250 255. Wow, I have that much money in here. I never know. Okay, so I already paid for June. Now this one is for July payment, and my July payment is on the 28th. So I still, and I paid $300. So wow, I only have a few more before I can close that month. I mean this month. So that's good. Utilities will get 30. So before I forget, utilities, we're just gonna put $30 in there. And then car insurance, how much? 35. So you have 20, 10, and 5. And then snowball debt is my Best Buy. I share this with my sister. So we have 10 already, and then I'm just gonna put 5. So we have $15 for Best Buy. And then you have 1, 2, 3, 4 for household. I think it's my turn to pay the mower. I'm not sure, but I'm just gonna put money in here. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I feel like this is a good $1 challenge. So those were doing the $1 challenge. This is like trigger warning. It's really pretty. And now this is my phone and my life insurance, but I'm not gonna stuff it this week. So that's it. We're empty on the tray, and that's everything for my monthly bills. I guess that's it. Oh my gosh, thank you guys so much for almost 900 subscribers. It's been a crazy June, and I'm just welcoming July with a fresher or a clear mindset. Now I'm trying so hard to heal myself also, so I hope to you guys feel the same way. I hope July will be good to you and the rest of the years and the days to come. And again, thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope to see you on the next one. Thank you, bye.